Welcome to lesson three of the Ultimate Resilience Building Health Optimizing 7-Step Guide to Performing Your Best, entitled Vital Waters. Vital Waters is actually broken down into two different parts. Vital waters, which are the fruits and vegetables that contain vitamins, minerals, and enzymes that your body can't make on its own, and water for the water that you drink. Vital waters. Recently, the FDA changed the food pyramid to back up what nutritionists have been saying for years. Fruits and vegetables are the foundational food group, not breads and cereals. As already mentioned, raw and slightly cooked fruits and vegetables contain several key ingredients you need in order to thrive. Here's a brief description. Vitamins. Vitamins are organic, meaning carbon-based molecules, with essential roles in the body. Their roles and their food sources vary greatly. Vitamin C, for instance, has immune system function, the B vitamins play metabolic roles, and vitamin K assists in blood clotting. Minerals. Minerals are very small chemicals which include positively charged particles of metallic elements and negatively charged particles of certain non-metallic elements. Like vitamins, minerals are essential to healthy cellular function, and you must obtain them from food. Some, such as sodium and potassium, have roles in fluid balance and are found in the blood and cellular fluid, while others, such as iron, become parts of larger protein molecules in the body. Enzymes. Enzymes are proteins that help chemical reactions take place faster than they otherwise would. They serve a wide variety of roles in the body and are very reaction-specific. Some enzymes operate in the digestive tract, while others help to burn nutrient compounds in the cells. Still, others play roles in muscle movement. Drinking water and proper hydration. Drinking water is important because of its many functions, namely transporting nutrients and oxygen into the cells, moisturizing the air in the lungs, assisting with metabolism, protecting our vital organs, helping organs to absorb nutrients better, regulating body temperature, detoxifying, and protecting our joints. As you can see, water is a very busy molecule in our bodies, and that is why it needs to be constantly drained and replaced. But how much water should you be drinking every day? What temperature is best? And what's the best kind of drinking water? These are the questions that I get asked most often about drinking water. The amount of water we drink each day really depends on our body's needs. A professional sumo wrestler will need more water, especially more than 8 glasses, than a librarian. People who are trying to lose weight, assuming that they're actually overweight, will usually be more dehydrated to begin with than individuals who are already at a healthy weight, and thus they should be drinking a higher percentage of water compared to their body weight. Additionally, people who are in the initial phase of a corrective NuCA spinal care plan should drink more water than usual because it's important that as the spine restructures itself, there is plenty water available to absorb into the discs. Healthy discs are about 90% water, while those affected by years of degeneration can have as little as 0 to 10%. In other words, the disc is practically gone. But as a general rule, a person's body weight in pounds divided by 2 is the number of ounces of water that a person should drink each day. This could seem like a lot at first, but it is worth ensuring that your joints and tissues are properly hydrated. If you find yourself having to go to the bathroom all the time after a couple of weeks of this, go ahead and cut back to a more comfortable amount. Lastly, people with kidney conditions should be careful not to overdrink water. Room temperature water is usually the best. If you drink a large glass of water and then try to do the hula hoop a half hour later, chances are that you will hear that water still sloshing around in your stomach. This is because your body will not absorb or pass the water until it is heated to near body temperature. The problem with drinking cold water is that you're spending energy to heat the water now, so it might make you tired after a while. So use your energy to use a little bit of both the blue and red spouts at the water cooler, and don't forget that it's also a water heater. One of a few exceptions to this rule is when athletes are performing under severe conditions in the heat and water is needed as a coolant. As for the best kind of drinking water, that's a difficult question to answer because although spring water is usually the best for most people, bottlers are allowed to say that theirs is spring water, while 40% of the bottled water companies out there are nothing more than glorified tap water, municipal tap water. Your best bet is to get a reverse osmosis filter for your home. See Mercola.com, Mercola.com for details on that. What's not controversial is the names and labels on these bottles are just wonderful. Deer Park, Aquafina, Ice Mountain, Ozarka, I'm getting thirsty already, Zephyr Hills, Poland Spring, Clearly Canadian, and Dasani. What's also certain is that your body's pH, which is measured in the urine and saliva, should be at least a little alkaline. Water ionizers and adding certain salts to the water can have many health benefits. The trick is not only getting to this point, but staying at the point where your stomach is acidic enough and doesn't become over-alkalized, which can cause problems with breaking down food eventually, especially if you're a meat eater like most people are. For more information on alkalizing, see phmiracleliving.com. Now you know why consuming vital waters is vital to your health success.